Hi, and congratulations on completing week five interpreting historiography. Now, I'm going to make this a really short 3 or 4 minute video, kind of highlighting some of the things I was looking for. On whole, the class did a really good job on these assignments. And so I want to blow through it, give you some thoughts, and then we can all go have Thanksgiving. So our goals this week were to demonstrate an understanding of the basic literary features of the historical books, to observe key literary features of historiography in the Book of Ruth, and to explain how literary features contribute to the meaning of the Book of Ruth. So we're looking at literary features. For assignment 5.1, you were to do a character study. And on whole, people did a really good job. I wanted you to evaluate the author's rendering of this character that you choose in the text and answer the following questions. How do they contribute to the overarching plot? Are they static or dynamic? And to evaluate the, what is their interaction like with the other characters in the narrative, and how is the author's presentation of them supposed to impact the reader? Now, a lot of you did what I thought was a great job, making each one of these four a section of your paper. That's a great way to dissect an assignment and say, okay, there are four things that professor is looking for. I am going to address each one in a paragraph or two, and that I thought went really well. I saw a lot of personal reflection, which is great. A lot of folks picked Naomi and really dove into her historical context and theological position, and that was awesome. I did want to see some outside research. I also wanted to see some biblical support. If there was a part of this assignment that was wanting, it really was how does the Book of Ruth and how does the character you chose play into the trajectories that we find for the Book of Ruth in the New Testament. And that would have made perfect some of the assignments that were very good. Then moving on to 5.2, which was an interpretive method blog. In about a 500-word blog, I wanted you to defend a position on diachronic versus synchronic methods. Most did a really good job on this. Some folks needed to dive into the definition of diachronic and synchronic, and how they differ and what methods fall into each. So I wanted you in this blog to say which methods are diachronic and which methods are synchronic, recognizing that an evangelical position is easier on the synchronic, and yet as evangelical scholars, we have to still utilize the diachronic methods. We just have to be aware of their evangelical shortcomings, or their shortcomings from an evangelical point of view. So on whole, folks did a good job. I was looking for a definition of each. I was looking for a paragraph on Chisholm and then a paragraph on reflection. And I wanted to see some outside interaction beyond Chisholm and Erickson. Finally, in your discussion post, it said using logos, look up and examine the most frequently repeated words throughout the Book of Ruth. Most folks did that. I wanted to see evidence or at least a statement. I looked up on Logos and found these top five words, of which this is the word that's most meaningful. Some folks weren't quite as clear, and I took a little bit of a deduction for that. If I felt like it looked like you just picked a word and ignored the most frequent words, I took a deduction for that, because as the assignment is written, you should start with, here is a list of the most frequent words, and then kind of move down to the word that you think is theologically most important. So that's a quick summary of this week's assignments. Have a great Thanksgiving, and I'll talk to you soon.